Right, so I'm just going to talk about the Onis. I'm going to show you, if you don't know how to operate them and how to get them to come in and get them to try and fly around the base to take out bunkers, because that's what they're really good for at the moment. Booty, low repair time, and we need 5, maybe 6 for a base. So I'm going to just show you in a Iron Strike. So you got a bit, when you're going to attack, you need to watch for your deploy point for your air. And yes, I'm making this for Derek, so so as you can see on my little map, my aeroplane comes in where my platoon is, and this is on the bottom left. So always make sure you got Ruby turned off. Zoom out so you've got full screen. And you've got to be pretty quick once you deploy. So if your air is coming in at the bottom left, then it's pretty easy because you're just clicking it out. It's just like any other normal unit, which is super fast. You know, it's a one of the probably the fastest units in the game. So they are pretty hard. They are. If I go that close into a base, and so what I'm just showing you is that if you're in control, it'll keep to the edge once it shoots you and fly back out. Obviously it's got its turning radius. It does seem pretty, you know, it has a large turning radius, as you can see. You couldn't do this in a base. Derek, don't ex, it's pretty hard to do this in a base, so. Yeah, obviously you can just try a bit harder now. And I think if you click in one direction, it flies that direction. So obviously it's like flew left. So I'll take, if I click over here, I'll take, it kind of just gets stuck on the outside. It'll, so it's like just over there somewhere. And you can leave it, I think. You know, I don't know if it's any different in an actual attack on a base, but just trying to, oh there it is, fucking hell. lost it. Oh, there it is. Yeah, wherever you click, it just flies in that direction and continues in the path. But obviously, if you know it's going off the screen, you just need to try and be fast in clicking. If you retreat that since it's been damaged, the next one comes out full health. There you go, just to kind of. It is pretty tricky, like, you know, when you deploy. So that's kind of coming in and flying to the right. I'm just gonna obviously just hit CC up. And I'm gonna try on a different direction the deployment for this. To see if it actually goes in anti-clockwise. There's another, it's like on the opposite that side. Tack in. Obviously me air comes in the top right, as I'll show you with the Titan. There you go, da-da. And I've got a clue where Mione is in that one. Yeah. In the base this time. So obviously, you know, Onis can hit floaters and anything, you know. A bit more difficult it is on a base, obviously, because you can't zoom out. The bases are that big, so don't laugh at it. It's just testing. Yeah, so you know, have concussion, whatever. So yeah, good for taking out bunkers. I would say probably a level 4. 4 or 5 bunker. And a repair time. Obviously I've got like 3 damaged here, so price of that. Taking out bunkers isn't going to be that expensive, especially when bunkers do a lot of damage to some of your units. And if people work together, you know, that's an hour's repair on, say, one and a half only. So, if people on different dies, you know, if you've got someone on the top left of the map and someone on the top right of the map, or someone, you know, like, so the onis can come in from different directions, you could have, you know, someone deploying from the bottom left to take out, you know, this bunker and that bunker, and someone on the top on the right can take out, you know, this bunker and that bunker, you know, and then you can take the rocket silos out, and it becomes, if you work as a team, you know, it kind of just makes your attack become cheaper and cheaper using onis, because if you take out most of them, the bunkers, the rocket silos, you know, and if you can take out, you know, the heavy platforms, you know, it becomes very cheap. Anyway, I think that should be it.